What's up, everybody? Welcome to the first ever 1010 Good Product Review. Today, I'll be reviewing the 2018 Asus 2-in-1 q536fd. Now, I know that if you clicked on this video because of the title, you're eager to hear why I think that this laptop is some solid competition for the Microsoft Surface Book 2. So let's go ahead and jump into how and why you might want to buy this laptop over the other.
We're going to start off with comparing the specs for both the 15-inch Surface Book 2 and the Asus Q. Both laptops use an 8th gen Intel Core i7 processor with 16GB of RAM. Both come with full Windows 10 and Windows Hello for easy login, and can be converted to a tent mode and tablet mode to watch videos and be extra portable. And that's about where the similarities end. A fully loaded 15-inch Surface Book 2 comes with an NVIDIA GTX 1060 graphics card, has the option to upgrade the standard 256GB SSD to 512 or even 1TB, and the screen can detach from the keyboard altogether to become a true tablet, unlike the other 2-in-1 laptops. So you're probably asking yourself right now, why don't I just get the Surface Book 2 then? And it's probably the same reason why you haven't already bought one.
It's freaking expensive! The base price alone for a 15-inch Surface Book is going to run you $1,500. Fully loaded, that price goes up to $3,200, and that does not include the extra $100 you're going to have to pay for the Surface Pen. Now, I don't know about you, but I ain't got the time for that. I ain't got the money for it, and I ain't got the time to save up for one. Now, if you have the cash and you just have to have a Surface Book, then go ahead and buy one. It's your choice. But if you're like me, a creator who's just starting out, you want a machine that's going to help you produce high-quality content quickly and efficiently. And the Asus does that. Not to mention it has the added bonus of you not wanting to scratch your eyes out when your next month's credit statement comes out.
So what makes the Asus such a better buy? Let's go back to the graphics. Yes, the Surface Book's GTX 1060 beats out the Asus's 1050. A GTX 1060 will allow a higher refresh rate when gaming, and it gives you the ability to handle 4K footage like a champ in Adobe Premiere. The issue the Surface Book has, though, is that it doesn't have an actual 4K display. It sits just shy with a resolution of 3240 by 2160, whereas the Asus has a full 3840 by 2160 4K display for watching videos and a slightly larger screen at 15.6 inches compared to the Surface Book's 15. Couple that with the fact that the Asus is Pantone validated to reproduce 100% of the sRGB color gamut, the Asus is the laptop to beat for photo manipulation and full HD video editing. With memory, there's absolutely no contest. The Asus wins. Sure, it only has one option, a 256GB solid-state hard drive, but it's also supported by a 2TB hard drive. A base Surface Book starts with a 256GB SSD and nothing else for $24.99. If you wanted to bump it up to a maximum 1TB, you'll have to dole out an extra $800 for it, bringing its already hefty price up to outrageous. Moving on to speakers, the Asus comes with two Harman Kardon stereo speakers that deliver a crisp sound with an almost surround sound feel to them. Check it out for yourself. Now on to a very important aspect for 2-in-1 laptops. Ports and portability. Believe it or not, the Asus is a tenth of an inch thinner when folded due to its hinge design. Microsoft's hinge design doesn't allow for the screen to fully close, but that doesn't matter too much since the screen detaches in tablet mode and becomes even thinner. The Asus is slightly wider to accompany the larger screen, while the Surface Book is taller to accommodate its 3:2 aspect ratio. And of course, weight is a heavy factor.
Boo, you stink!
The Surface Pro is a little bit lighter, weighing in at 4.2 pounds with a keyboard compared to the Asus at 4.63 pounds. But not only is that 0.4 of a pound negligible in my opinion, there's a good reason for it. Connectivity. The Surface Book comes with a full SD card reader as well as two USB Type A ports and one USB Type C. The Asus only has one of each USB Type ports, but it also comes with a full SD card reader, and both laptops include a headphone jack. But the one key feature that the Asus has over the Surface Book is that it has an HDMI port. This port not only accounts for its thicker looking frame, but adds a much needed availability to the laptop that the Surface Book just doesn't have. The Surface Book, however, requires you to purchase yet another piece of hardware, a USB to HDMI adapter that's going to run you an extra $40. And finally, what touchscreen computer would be complete without a stylus device? While the Asus doesn't use the Surface Pen, you can purchase a Wacom Bamboo stylus pen for $70 compared to the $100 you'll pay for the Surface Pen. Like the Surface Pen, the Bamboo Stylus is programmable, is optimized for Windows ink, and has the added bonus of including three different interchangeable tips to choose from depending on if you want a soft, medium, or hard writing style. So what did we learn here? After taxes, the Asus q536fd and Bamboo Stylus will run you just over $1,700. The Surface Book 2, with a terabyte of memory to match the Asus, the Surface Pen, and an HDMI adapter to equal the Asus's capabilities, will bring you to a whopping $3,438 and some change before taxes. That's a difference of $1,673.50. To put that into perspective, here's a small list of things you can buy with that kind of money. Now, of course, there is no such thing as a perfect laptop, and the Asus is not without its own set of drawbacks. I found the trackpad to be a little bit lacking in its intuitiveness. When I tried to click and drag to highlight photos or videos, it sometimes wouldn't recognize that I was using two fingers, and scrolling occasionally lagged. This definitely shouldn't be a deal breaker though, because not even Microsoft can match the technology that Apple has put into their trackpads. To this day, MacBooks still have the market cornered with intuitive trackpads and gestures. And those nice loud speakers you heard? Asus decided to put them on the bottom of the laptop for some reason. Again, not a deal breaker. When I'm editing on a hard surface, I couldn't tell a difference in sound quality. But when you put the laptop on a soft surface, especially in tent mode, a blanket can easily push up against the speakers and muffle the sound coming out. And of course, the Bamboo Stylus isn't quite as advanced as a Surface Pen. How can it be? It was designed by Microsoft for Microsoft. The Bamboo Stylus isn't quite as quick to access functions, I found, and it also lacks the tilt feature that the Surface Pen has. This, though, would only be a potential issue if you're a graphic artist. Otherwise, the Bamboo will be just fine for day-to-day operations. The final design flaw is the bevel on the outside of the laptop. Asus decided to make it flush with the rest of the laptop, which doesn't sound bad. It keeps the machine looking sleek and streamlined, but it makes it less than easy to open. So now that we've gone over the good and the not-so-good things about the 2018 Asus 2-in-1, what kind of scores is it going to get for our 10-10 good product review? The Asus 2-in-1 laptop is a really good piece of machinery. It's got hardware and software that either matches or surpasses that of the Microsoft Surface Book 2. However, because of certain design choices that Asus made, I feel like those things are what keep this laptop from really coming out ahead of other brand name products. Overall though, I think an 8 out of 10 is a really good score for something that costs this much less over the leading brand laptops.
Alright guys, that about does it for my review of the 2018 Asus 2-in-1 laptop. I hope you liked it. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel for more videos, and stay tuned for next time when I give the name brand product its due and review the Microsoft Surface Book 2 15-inch. Take care.